Hello people, in this video we want to look at the benefits of breastfeeding. So breast milk is the ideal food for neonates, okay? It's the best gift that a mother can give her child. So basically it contains everything that the baby needs for normal growth and development for the first 6 months of life. Later it is not sufficient, so you'll have to add some complementary feeds. So exclusive breastfeeding for 6 months has the potential to reduce under 5 mortality rate by 13%. So if you exclusively breastfeed, that means give breast milk and no other food, that should be reducing the mortality, okay, of the baby, okay. But you can still add vitamin drops. Along with this breast milk, you can still give vaccines and vitamins, etc. you can give, okay. So, what else? Now, what are the benefits of breast milk? This is what we want to know. Now, breast milk contains all the nutrients that a baby needs, that we already told you. Then it is in the right proportion and in the right form. So, it gets easily digested and absorbed. Now, let us come to carbohydrates. Lactose is high in concentration. And galactose, necessary for the formation of galactocerebrosides, so brain development. Lactose helps in absorption of calcium and enhances the growth of lactobacilli, the good bacteria in the intestine. So what are the benefits of lactose? So galactocerebrosides in absorption of calcium, growth of lactobacilli, the good bacteria. So three things you got here, okay. Now let us look at the composition of milk. Look at this, they have told here lactose is more in the human milk, okay. It is less in colostrum, so that's not tasty, the colostrum. So but anyways, lactose is more in human milk compared to cow milk, buffalo milk, etc. Okay, now we are done with lactose. Then let's look at the other things. Now let's move to proteins. Proteins, the content of breast milk is, protein content of breast milk is low, okay. Actually it is low. Most of the protein is in the form of lact albumin and lact globulin, which is easily digested. But whatever is there is in a better form that it can be digested easily. Lact albumin, lactoglobulin. You have to write these specific things, otherwise you won't get marks, okay? Human milk contains amino acids like taurine, cysteine, which are necessary for neurotransmission and neuromodulation. So again, what is the use of taurine, cysteine, etc.? These amino acids will help in neurotransmission and neuromodulation. These are lacking in cow milk and formula. Please note this. So look at proteins mentioned here. Proteins are less in the human one compared to the cow and buffalo, but these are more easily digestible. Lactoalbumin and lactoglobulin are present in the mother's milk, which is easy for the baby to digest. Okay. And there are amino acids like taurine and cysteine, which will help in neurotransmission and neuromodulation. These are all lacking in cow and cow milk and formula. Now let us go to breast milk and fats. So breast milk is rich in polyunsaturated fatty acids, PUFA. PUFA. PUFA is more in breast milk. Okay. So let's move that here. PUFA is more in breast milk. Then. It is necessary for the myelination of the nervous system. So myelination of the nervous system, the myelin sheath to form around the nerves. This is very important. What is important? Fatty acids, polyunsaturated fatty acids. It also contains omega 2 and omega 6, very long chain fatty acids, which are important for the formation of prostaglandins and cholesterol. Oh, prostaglandin also is a type of coming from fatty acids, is it? Nice. So if you want to make cholesterol, prostaglandins, you should understand that there is good cholesterol, right? High density high density lipoprotein. So basically it will help in the myelination of nervous system. And omega 2 and omega 6, please say these guys, otherwise you will not remember. PUFA, omega 3 and omega 6, very long chain fatty acids, are responsible for the manufacture of prostaglandin and cholesterol. Baby is getting cholesterol and prostaglandins, the good cholesterol, okay, don't worry. And it is also myelinating the nervous system, okay. Now let us look at this here. Fats is almost same in both, okay. But what did you learn about fat? There is PUFA is there, and then omega 2 and omega 6 fatty acids, okay. So myelination of nervous system is happening from fats, but nervous system development, taurine, cysteine, etc. is happening from protein. So everything it needs, okay. So we have completed carbohydrates, proteins and fats, and that we have written here. Now look at this. Now in comparison also we wrote correctly. Carbohydrates first. Okay. And then proteins and then fats. Now we are done. With this much we are done. Okay. Lactose, proteins, fats. This much we have finished. Now let's continue. Vitamins and minerals are sufficient to the needs of the baby for the first 6 months of life. Okay. But I think vitamin D is less. Vitamin D is less than, less than needed. It is less than needed. Though it is more than what is in cow's milk, it is less than needed, it says. Okay. And if a person is a vegetarian, not at all eating non-veg and all, and they can have less vitamin K, B12 and all that, they can have less. Okay. So according to textbook, it is sufficient for baby, but according to some other sources here, they are saying that vitamin D, K, B12 and all are a little less. Okay. Now, what about iron and calcium and all? Let's look at that. They did not specially say anything about this, but iron is in more absorbable type, they are saying. Calcium, phosphorus are in proper ratio. The ratio is good of calcium and phosphorus or something with human milk. Okay. 100 ml of breast milk gives 66 calories, guys. This is what they will ask you. How much calories will it give? It will give 66 calories, 100 ml. Okay, 100 ml of breast milk will give 66 calories. Water content will be around 88% of the breast milk. Okay. See, breast milk has water content of 88%. This we told you. So, it does not require any additional water for the first few months. Okay. So, just breastfeed. But you have to breastfeed a lot. Remember this. That is what they are saying. Exclusive breastfeeding means it's not that don't give anything else. It also means that you have to breastfeed a lot. On demand, give a lot. Baby should not cry and want more. You give more, but don't take it so much to heart if you can't, and you can think of complementary feeds to help you. Okay. Now look at this immunological superiority. Breast milk contains a number of protective factors. This is very important. Immunoglobulins that is going to the baby from mother. Secretory IgA. Okay. Macrophages go, lymphocytes go, lactoferrin goes, lysozyme goes, bifidus factor goes, interferon goes, what and all goes to the baby from the mother. Say IgA only we knew actually. We will always say immunoglobulins will go. But macrophages, lymphocytes, lactoferrin, lysosomes, bifidus factor, interferon. What is this bifidus factor? This bifidus factor is something that encourages growth of normal flora. Okay. Growth of intestinal flora. Bacterial flora, it will help in growth. Okay. That is this thing. What? Bifidus factor. Okay. So, macrophages, lymphocytes, lactoferrin, lysozymes, bifidus factor and interferon. These you have to mention. Okay. A breastfed baby is 14 times less likely to die of diarrhea and 4 times less likely to die of respiratory infection. So, what it won't get? Diarrhea and respiratory infection. Okay. So, what are we looking at? Benefits of breast milk. So, these are immunological helps. Okay. Other benefits. Breast milk contains number of growth factors, enzymes and hormones. See, hormones also are going to baby. Mother's hormones are also going to baby. So, maturation of the intestinal cells reduces risk of allergy. So, basically intestinal maturation, risk of allergy will reduce, etc. Enzymes like lipases increase digestion of fats in the milk. So, enzymes also are coming from mother to child. So, lipases will increase the digestion of fat digestion, okay, in the milk. So, it's mother is giving milk and giving lipases it. So, it will help the digestion of the fat in the milk. At least the fat part in the milk will get digested. So, to this table we are adding now, what and all extra things are coming? Secretory IgA, macrophages, lymphocytes, lactoferrin, lysosomes, bifidus factor, interferon, growth factor, enzymes, hormones. A breastfed baby has less ear infection and orthodontic problems. That means teeth also won't have problem, they are saying. So the benefits of breast milk for the baby, it will have low risk for diabetes, heart disease and lymphoma. So now that I have done breastfeeding when I was a kid, I will have low risk of diabetes, heart disease and lymphoma. I better not get these, okay? I've been breastfed. Diabetes, no way. But hereditary will I get? Heart disease, lymphoma. Okay guys, focus. What do you think? You are susceptible or not to lymphoma, etc.? Just go check with your mom. Mental growth. How is your mental growth? Baby who are breastfed are better bonded to their mothers. Bonding. Okay. Studies have shown that babies who were breastfed have higher IQ than those who were given other forms of milk. Other forms of milk are not so good according to the textbook, but I don't know why I feel like you should not criticize so much about it. Okay. Coming to benefits to mother also will benefit. What will it help for the mother? Uterine involution. Why? Because of oxytocin. Then chances of reducing postpartum hemorrhage. Yes, because the uterus is involuting. Protection against pregnancy. Very good. Lactational amenorrhea. She will not get pregnant if she is exclusively breastfeeding. Right, but it can happen, this can fail, so you should be careful. You can still get pregnant while breastfeeding, be careful. If the mother has been exclusively breastfeeding her baby and has not resumed menses, there is no need for any other contraception during the initial 6 months of delivery. Exclusively breastfed her baby and has not resumed her menses, but it can happen that she did not get her menses because she is pregnant also. So it is not the safest way, but they are saying that if you have exclusively breastfed, there is no need of other contraception. Anyways, that is what the textbook says. Breastfeeding is most convenient and time-saving. It's convenient, time-saving. Come on, add it. It's cheap. Why didn't you say that? It's cheap. It's free. Why do you say it's cheap? Say it's free. Then, it reduces the risk of cancer of breast and ovary. Yes, why? Because she has lactational amenorrhea. So there is no, so risk of cancer of breast and ovary are reduced. Breastfeeding is most effective way of shedding extra weight. So you can shed extra weight. So just to please the women who are concerned about pregnancy weight and all that, they'll say you just breastfeed and you will lose the extra weight. Okay. Not sure where I read this, but definitely if it is a preterm baby, the mother compensates for that a lot in her breast milk, isn't it? So these are all the benefits of breastfeeding, guys. We have just summarized it here. Carbohydrates, proteins, fats, vitamins, iron, calcium, phosphorus, then all these immunoglobulins, growth factor enzymes, hormones, and it protects against a lot of diseases. Then bonding for the mother. For the mother, the benefits are that it will help her in uterine involution. Postpartum hemorrhage, it will stop. She can lose weight and lactational amenorrhea. She won't get pregnant if she's exclusively breastfeeding, etc. That's it for now, guys, in this video on benefits of breastfeeding. So I'm sure you can write a lot more than the points here, right? That's it for now. Bye bye.